Hello students, we learn about the computers today, that how the computers are going to be useful for it, especially for making textile designs. In order to remain competitive both in the global and domestic markets, the textile industry had brought in various transformations that have taken place in the textile industry through information technology to face the challenge of being profitable in a highly competitive global market by rapidly delivering value to a diverse base of consumers. Computers are making their way into the design rooms of major companies. In today's world, computer-aided textile designing becomes versatile for all the designing and weaving industry. More than the just automate business functions, these computers are being used to create intricate designs. Designers and product managers are embracing CAD systems as the way to get their work done in a fraction of the time of traditional methods. Even more, CAD is seen as a way to streamline communication between design and production. Far from being an exotic tool for only high-end companies, CAD has become mainstream and a necessity. Computer-aided designing is the process of designing from concept to final product with the help of computers. So, we will see what are the advantages of these CAD systems. The expense and time is reduced in a considerable manner when compared to the laborious manual work of designing. Designing can be done from anywhere as the customers are able to control the process from remote locations as well. The data can be easily stored, transmitted and transported through computer files. Transfer of images and drawings into the computer becomes very easy, and the use of an image for any number of times is possible, like we can look for croquis and weave diagrams which we can again get back and then we can work on it. And the color manipulation like RGB, that is red, green and blue. CMYK, maybe for printing and all, that is cyan color, yellow, magenta and black, and HSV, that is hue, saturation, value. So, all these things can be easily done. Digital swatches can be saved on CD-ROM or pen drive or some hard drive, and thus saving space, and moreover they can be easily organized for fast and easy retrieval. The designs can be easily customized and personalized, as corrections and editing can be easily done at any time without significant delays or adding costs. And the designers do not need to produce swatches all the time, as they can now see how a particular fabric or garment looks in different colors and shapes on computer screen itself, because there are virtual images that we can create on the computer. Communication with consumers has become more effective, as virtual images can be created simulating the drape of textiles for different end users. And then we will see what are the types of CAD systems that are available in the market. One is the design studio, and other one is illustration or sketch pad, and maybe texture mapping for embroidery and specification and costing, digitizing for grading and marker making, pattern design software, pattern generation software. So, all these modules are available in the market, and depending upon whether it is in apparel design or textile design, we should be able to take up the software. So, these CAD systems offer value by performing the functions such as develop new styling and design the appropriate garment construction, create numerous style variations quickly and draw the new silhouettes, and line development in garment industries for production and all, and design new textiles, design shoes and accessories, and design retail displays, and combine graphics and typesetting for marketing aids and presentations, and then enhance the public relations image of the company, design labels and logos, and create artwork and color stories for silk screen applications, and then 3D texture mapping. Globally, CAD has revolutionized the design process undoubtedly. CAD designs became instantly recognizable and appreciated through images that are created throughout the world. Creativity, design process, and the effective management of both are important factors in maintaining and extending market position and market share. Low-cost PC-based systems used for automating pattern design, grading, marking, plotting accelerates design creations into pattern making in a matter of hours. This has a revolutionary effect not only within the factory but throughout the world of fashion. Even though a number of CAD systems are available in the market, many of them are highly expensive and are not within the reach of the small and medium based industries. Therefore, affordable CAD systems seems to be the norm in the university classrooms, as they do train the future personnel required for the industries. Affordable software that fulfills the designer's graphic programs for the industry is Adobe Photoshop. It allows manipulation of different colors, textures without really making the samples and help in customization of the designs. For making a creating textile designs and all, we need a CAD station. And for setting up of the ideal CAD station, what are the hardware and the software requirements? Let us see. Setting up a CAD station involves assembling several components. That is, these include a monitor or video display, a central processing unit, input devices such as a mouse, a digitizer, a scanner, and output devices such as printers and plotters. The configurations of these components may change very frequently, and hence a thorough market survey is recommended before buying. However, making budget-wise selections that satisfy both current and future needs saves time and money. And what type of hardware is required? Selection of a monitor or video display in this. And to work with all CAD softwares, it is better to select the largest monitor with the best resolution, as it facilitates greatest ease in working. A 15-inch monitor is a standard monitor that may not fulfill the requirement. A 24-inch monitor, which costs a little more than the standard one, may be an ideal tool for viewing the designs. A 27-inch to 34-inch monitors are also available, which are very expensive and affordable only by few. A resolution of at least 640 by 480 dots per inch is a must for the standard monitors, and resolutions of 1024 into 768 dots per inch or 1280 into 1024 dots per inch or even better than that are optimal for designing. Resolutions as high as 3840 by 2160 dots per inch are also available for excellent picture clarity. Monitors with high performance cards are available, which enables the display of around 256 colors at the same time. Flat screens deliver a crisper, more distortion free display across the screen. LED monitors offer a brighter image than LCDs, smaller and require less power, and they allow for extremely thin cabinet designs. And then we organize the central processing unit. The central processing unit is the computer's activity center, and after processing the software and user input, it sends instructions to the monitor, printer, plotter or other peripheral devices. The CPU's speed and efficiency affects its performance and user productivity. Speeds of CPU differ, and around 50 megahertz speed is the least speed required for any type of CAD. The greater the speed, the less time it takes for the drawing to regenerate. The kind of processor used also affects the CPU's processing power. RAM or random access memory is the storage space that holds the drawing and program while they are in use. RAM should be based on the requirement of the software used for designing, and a RAM of 128 megabytes. may be the minimum requirement for design work. Today we are getting much more speeder RAM that are available, and so it is very easy to work with them, and retrieval of the designs and the changes that we bring in, the editing of the designs also will be very fast. Design work consumes a lot of space than text in a computer. Scanned pictures form larger files that occupy lot of space. For convenience, the CPU should contain external drives such as CD drive or CD writers, pen drives or hard disk and many other things that are coming today to provide external space for storage of information and flexibility of use. The CPU should also have few expansion slots for future upgradation. And these can be used for additional serial and parallel ports, extra memory, video cards and other enhancements. Non-integrated motherboards are better than integrated motherboards, as the former facilitates replacing of its components individually. Selection of these pointing devices such as mouse, digitizers and stylus, and it is the easiest way to draw and edit by using of these pointers such as mouse, cursor or stylus, and it allows the user to move around quickly and to select items from dialog boxes and from screens pull down and icon menus. Using the cursor or arrow keys is the alternative to using a pointing device, which is extremely slow and tedious. Select a mouse or cursor or stylus with as many buttons as possible. With every additional button, drawing becomes faster and easier. AutoCAD provides functions for about 10 buttons. A mouse is often the most affordable pointing device. Generally, it has 2 or 3 buttons which pick points on the screen, press enter and display the menu of the object, snap mode. Super mouse that have 40 or more buttons are now available with many built-in features and programmed by user to perform other functions. The digitizer is an electronic input device that makes all AutoCAD's features more accessible and greatly enhances the productivity. An additional benefit is the ability to input existing patterns and illustrations. The printing device attached to the digitizer is called a cursor or puck. It can be purchased with 4, 8, 12 or 16 buttons. A stylus can also be used with the digitizer. Digitizers are available in different sizes. The 12 by 12 inches and 12 by 17 inches tablets are considered working digitizers. They are also useful for inputting the patterns and illustrations. Larger items may, however, have to be digitized in sections. Digitizers are also available up to a maximum of 40 inches to 60 inches, which are highly expensive but provide utmost flexibility for working with. The stylus is a pen-like plotting device. It is often available with or without a digitizer. Because of its shape and size and the number of buttons that it contains, its functions may be limited. Stylus offers freedom and familiarity for sketching and freehand drawing. Selecting a scanner. So, the scanner is an optical device, illuminates the drawing with a fluorescent or incandescent light. The reflected light passes through a lens and undergoes a process that converts it into a raster image. The level of a scanner is an important aspect for getting perfect images. A 8-bit pixel offers around 256 gray values. A 24-bit images, or actually 3 8-bit channels, one for each red, green and blue light. A 24-bit scanner captures around 256 shades of gray, and this 256 three times gives around 16.7 million possible colors, which may be maximum for graphic designs. A 256 56 level indicates its ability to record 256 color shades that provide accurate images. Resolution is another important factor in selecting the scanner. Most of the scanners have 150 dpi as default resolution, but adjustable to lower and higher resolutions also as per the activity. Then coming to the selection of the output devices like printers and plotters, they are the major output devices required for pattern making and fashion illustration. Resolution, speed, size, memory, color capacity and ease of use are the main criteria for the selection of these output devices. Coming to the printers, printers are useful for providing illustrations, test plots and half and quarter scale list patterns. Often limited to A and B sized paper, their chief limitation is size. They are cost effective and varieties of printers are available in the market, which include dot matrix, laser and inkjet models. Printers output is based on the required resolution. Up to 2400 dots per inch resolution is possible now. Generally, many printers have an option for resolution of low, medium and high. A printer of latest configuration that suits for computer should be acquired. Inkjet printers are available at very competitive price, but further maintenance including the cost of the cartridges should be taken into consideration while selecting these printers. Then coming to the selection of a plotter, size is the most important factor in selection of plotters. A plotter that produces e-sized, that is 48 inches or larger, is ideal for full scale patterns or designs. Narrower devices sometimes make it necessary to plot the patterns in two or more sections. Plotters that accept several paper sizes are the most useful. Plotters are available in two basic styles. One is a drum style and the other one is flatbed. Drum plotters have the advantage of standing upright and require little space. A roll feed attachment can be made to feed the paper of various sizes continuously for plotting larger patterns. An adapter blade that replaces the pen enables several types of drum plotters to function as pattern cutters. And this is useful in case of apparel patterns and all. Flatbed plotters accept media of varied types and thickness, including poster board. Because paper remains flat, these plotters take lot of space than drum plotters. Speed is an important issue when selecting a pen plotter. So, pen speed is measured in inches per second. A plotter speed of 20 inches per second is acceptable for most applications. Automatic paper sizing is another time saving factor. Many electronic plotters are raster devices and which form images composed of dots. Their resolution is measured in dots per inch and most have resolutions from 150 to 400 dots per inch. While selecting plotters, especially for supporting apparel software, compatibility is essential. The apparel CAD systems sometimes supply their own digitizers and plotters in order to have better compatibility. If the compatibility is not there, it becomes a white elephant because it's a costly affair. Coming to the selection of the software, invention of high resolution color graphics computer has opened its use in textile design all over the world and has helped in reducing the time required from design conception to sample production. Computer aided Dobby and Jacquard design packages and retrofit kit for automation of Jacquard piano card punching machine has been developed. Print design package has been added to it and now the complete CATD packages is being offered, that means computer aided textile design packages is being offered And this software provides a tool to designer to increase his creativity, productivity and efficiency to experiment with fresh ideas. Care should be taken before buying any CAD software. The softwares which are supported by the available hardwares should only be purchased, or the hardware should be upgraded to comply with the new software. Training too has to be given to the operator for operating the system so that maximum benefit may be taken from it. With careful selection and trained professionals, the textile industry can enjoy the benefits of the IT revolution right at their door. Over 100 vendors that supply software offer competitive price to the buyers. Software that have special features are often priced very high, making them not affordable for by many. General softwares such as CorelDRAW for creating and rendering designs, Adobe Photoshop that helps in image editing, are added advantages to the designer. MS Office software that virus detectors, animation and rendering software, those things would be ideal if added to the setup for setting up of a CAD working station. Coming to the textile design software modules that are available in the market, we can see that exclusive softwares are available in the market for textile design today, and they are available in the form of specific modules for each application. In case of textile design, one is woven or dobby designs, that is one module, printing designs is another module, and jacquard designs another module, carpet design and knitting design, embroidery design, 3D images or design, and 3D showroom. These are the some of the modules that are available under the textile design. In the woven dobby design module, we have yarn formation, the pattern has to be formed, and then the fabric design or fabric formation has to be assigned. And for getting the printing designs, maybe for prints or making the designs, and for silk screen printing and all, modules are creation of motifs, and basic motifs can be rotated, translated, scaled and copied, preparation of color palette. Once the designer is satisfied, it can be copied on a color printer. Color separation for preparation of screens or rollers, and analysis of designs for printing. For the module, jacquard design module, and the thing is that we have to create the design just like in printing, and then convert the design into graphical representation, and then selection of weaves from the library, and then the punching of the card should take place. And coming to the carpet designs module, and here also the design has to be created, and we have to select the repeat, the define the size of the carpet, and then define the knottage of the carpet that is required, and then visualize the carpet and the color monitor, and save the motifs and design in the file, and then printing. In case of knitting design module, here we have to create a set of rib in graph mode, and the selection of the structure design, color codes for a body structure, and then creation of patterned library. And then in case of embroidery designs, we have to create the designs and then run the machine with the different color combinations and stitches. Instructions to be given to operate 10 to 15 machines simultaneously at a time. And so these are some of the modules that are available in the market. Each company will have their own specifications of the monitor, and also the instructions are being given, and even the software instructions are different, and by following the instructions and the training that an operator receives, and they will be easily operating these things. And all these softwares are very user friendly, and so operator, if he is trained, he can do it very well. And so all the designers, most of the designers use the softwares today, and they can easily use them and then can create the designs. And in case when you have a laborious making of designs? I'm sure that definitely textile designers who are real making with the hand, you know, the drawing and all, they will be able to produce creative designs. But the one or two, taking the one or two creative designs, we can make hundreds of designs in the computer. That is the use of these designs. And the designs which are already created, which are already there in their library, can be utilized for making many more designs. And thus, you know, CAD is an essential element in the industries, especially in the textile industry.